Matt Lund here with Steve Bernhardt at Baseball Factory Headquarters. We're talking about the 2016 Under Armour All-America Game, July 23rd at Wrigley Field. And today, Steve, we're going to go over some of our talented infielders that will be there this year, beginning with the two-time Under Armour All-American, Alex Corral.
Yeah, Alex was great as a rising junior last year. He's back, even stronger. Left-hand bat that is really advanced. He's got a mature approach at the plate. He has for years. Plays an excellent first base as well. And he's got some power in that bat. Earlier in the high school season, he went upper deck at Marlins Park, one of their high school games, and we should see a taste of that, certainly at Wrigley. Another first baseman that we have, a left-handed hitter with another advanced approach, is Nick Prado. Nick, several years ago, got the game-winning walk-off single to beat Japan for his Huntington Beach team to win the Little League World Series. So he's been doing this for a long time. He's got a knack for clutch hits, barrels everything, doesn't really feel the pressure, it seems like. Just a calm, cool, collected guy and an advanced hitter.
And one of two underclassmen that are in this game this year, Steve, is corner infielder Tristan Cassis.
Yeah, Tristan plays third base and first base. He even jumps on the mound and runs his fastball into the low 90s. Right now, he's a 2019 grad, which is a young guy for the game. But he's 6'4", big and strong, fits right in physically, and he may have the best hit-power combination in the high school ranks.
Let's talk some middle infielders now. The first one up here on the list, Steve, we saw at the 2016 Under Armour All-America preseason tournament, and that's Brady McConnell.
Yeah, Brady's a talented guy, one of the best all-around middle infielders that we have. He runs, looks like he can stay at short, has plenty of arm strength, swings a bat with a nice loose right-handed swing, and he's got some power. He's from Merritt Island High School. I believe the last first-round pick out of Merritt Island was Clint Hurdle, who's now the manager of the Pirates, had a nice big league career, does a lot of events with us at Baseball Factory, or has over the past several years, and Brady might add his name to that list of Merritt Island guys that are first-rounders. Another infielder, if we go to the other coast that we have, is Nick Allen. We saw Nick a couple years ago coming off of his freshman year in high school, and even at that time, he may have been the best defensive high school shortstop in the country, and he continues that. He's got an unbelievable knack for picking the right hop, reads balls off the bat great. He's got quick feet, tremendous hands. He's a confident fielder with plenty of arm strength and a line drive right-handed bat, so he'll be exciting to watch at Wrigley.
One player in particular from Canada, a lot of lineage there from Canada playing the Under Armour All-America game, and that's Adam Hall.
Yeah, Adam's a tremendous player, plays for the Canadian junior national team, actually just homered against Cuba, down in Cuba a couple days ago. We're excited to have Adam Hall. He's a plus runner, he's got plenty of arm strength. He's one of those true baseball players, you know, he plays it the right way. He may not wow you with some of the tools and things like that or the power, but he gets hits, he can hit home runs. He always seems to be in the mix helping the team out. And then we've got a couple other middle infielders that have tremendous tools. One is a little bit of an under-the-radar prospect out of New Jersey, Andrew Papantonis. We saw him at our Team One South event. Andrew's a plus runner with plus arm strength. He's got quick hands at the plate, that right-handed swing. He's an athletic guy. He's been a high school quarterback and wide receiver. He's a competitor. He plays the game real hard. We expect to see some big things from him. And another player with a lot of tools out of Puerto Rico is Ricardo De La Torre. We had Delvin Perez last year as a shortstop that was a first rounder. Ricardo looks to follow in those footsteps. Another guy ran a 6.55 for us at our event down in Florida, threw 90-something across the diamond. Quick feet, plays with great energy, a nice loose right-handed swing. He should be a real good one as well.
And then finally, two more guys here, Steve, playing both shortstop and third base, sort of in the mold of a Carter Kihoom or even further back, Nick Castellanos, and that's Ryan Mallade and Ben Ramirez.
Yeah, both of them have the ability to play shortstop. Don't know if they'll end up there or at third base. They've got the arm strength in both spots. Ryan Mallade, his father's assistant coach at Oklahoma State University. He was a longtime hitting instructor and scout. And you can see where Ryan's been raised the right way. He swings a bat with authority. Stuff comes off really hard off his bat. And he's relaxed, confident, loose in the box. Ben Ramirez is a left-handed hitter out of California. He has one of the prettiest swings in this class. You know, the lefties always look better anyway. But it's a sweet stroke. He barrels it up. He uses the whole field. As he gets bigger and stronger, he'll flash some more power, but he's a nice advanced bat also. Plays above average defense in the infield.
A lot of talented infielders this year at the Under Armour All-America Game. For more on the game and the players that are going to be there at Wrigley Field, go to baseballfactor.com/All-America.